Hey Scorpio, so let's get into this. So you guys, I know you guys hear my trap music going on in the background. That's how I do it over here. I like to trap while I read. If that's not something that you like, then this would not be the channel for you. We're gonna do a how do they view you, how do they feel about you spread. These readings are general. If it doesn't resonate with you, check your moon and rising sign. I read from the woman's perspective and the men that they're dealing with. If this resonates, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notification bell so that you'll get notified. Let's get into this. Call on my ancestors, angels, guides, and guardians. Give me a love message for Scorpio and the person that they are dealing with. You know how I read. You know how I interpret. Make the messages clear. So the mutual energy between you guys is the Three of Cups. So you guys could both want to reunite here, reconcile. You both could be hanging out, having fun, dating other people. They view you as a Queen of Wands, Scorpio. So they view you as somebody that they find attractive. They view you as somebody that's confident. They could view you, but they could also view you as someone who is intuitive with this black cat here. They could view you, so this is a fire. Sagittarius, Leo, Aries. They could view as a party girl too, or somebody that gets a lot of attention, because that Queen of Wands is very attractive. So how they feel about you and their emotions is the King of Pentacles. So they could feel that you're stable. They could feel, you know, that they want to have a foundation with you. They could feel like they want to be in a committed relationship with you, because that King of Pentacles is a husband. They could feel that you're financially stable. So, you know, be careful with that. If that's how they, you know, if that's one of the things that they, you know, if that's something that is important to them. I shouldn't say important to them. Just don't be a sugar mama. That's what I'm saying. Okay. And the outcome is the Two of Wands. So somebody here's got to make a decision. It seems like you got two different paths that you can go down here, or both of you do. And it looks like somebody here could be dealing with a fire sign again, but somebody's here trying to make a decision. See what path they're going to take. So both of you guys are the Ten of Swords. So somebody could feel like somebody else has them in a third party, or had them in a third party relationship, or have them in a third party relationship. Okay. With that Ten of Swords, somebody feels betrayed here. Could be dealing with an air sign. So were you guys both cheating on each other? What did I say about that black cat? Hold on a second. I thought I... Hey, you guys, I'm back. So what did I say about that, about them being, feeling like you were intuitive? They could feel like you're doing, they could view you as somebody who does work. And when I say work, I mean, you know, witchcraft, hoodoo, that type of thing. Because they view you as the magician and the Queen of Wands. We got that black cat there. So they could view you as a witch, a worker, a practitioner, whatever you want to call it. Could be dealing with a Gemini or a Virgo here. But also they could just view you as somebody who manifests what they want. Okay, so they could view you as somebody that gets what they want, makes it happen. So even though they feel that you're stable, or they feel in their emotions that you're stable, or maybe even wife material, or somebody that they can have a family or in a lifetime with, or a long-term relationship with, they also could feel like you've taken a break from them, or they feel like they need a break. Could be dealing with a Gemini. So I feel like somebody here has a choice between two lovers, which is what we see in this mutual energy over here. So somebody here has a choice between two lovers. I'm sorry that this is shaking. I'm trying to get it where all the cards are in view. But I feel like somebody here has a choice between two lovers. Could be dealing with a Gemini. It's a lot of Gemini energy here. The lovers is the major arcana for Gemini. So this is somebody who has a choice, a decision. Because not only is the lovers about, you know, love relationships, but it's also about decisions and choices. So somebody has a choice here, and I feel like it's a choice between two lovers. Because as we see right here, somebody was in a third party. Yeah, somebody here was definitely given, somebody here is either receiving less than they were giving, or if you look at this card, somebody's not getting anything and this person is getting everything. So somebody here was dealing with more than one person. There's three people in this card, three people in this card, three people in that card. Okay, so definite third party energy. So they view you somebody who is defensive, who is blocking them. So you could have them blocked. You could have them blocked physically, but you could also just be blocking them out emotionally, or just not dealing with them, being very defensive, on guard. And I feel like they're losing their strength here with this strength card in reverse. Could be dealing with a Leo. So I feel like they're losing their strength, and they could be losing their patience here also. Okay. Scorpio, I feel like you're going to choose the other person. I feel like you're going to choose the other person because you're moving away from this situation. So the outcome is that somebody here, which is you, has a decision between two lovers, and it looks like you're moving on to calmer waters here, or you're moving on from this relationship. So I got a feeling that you're going to pick the other person. Okay. So this relationship won't be coming back together is what I see. Okay, Cancer, you're up next. Give me a message for the Cancers. Give me a love message for the Cancers and the person that they're dealing with. Give me a love message for Cancer. You know how I read. You know how I interpret. And it's seen the Eight of Pentacles, so somebody here wants to work on something. You know how I interpret. Make the messages clear. So the mutual energy between you guys is the King of Pentacles. So both of you guys are looking for stability. Both of you guys are looking for a long-term commitment. Both of you guys are could be focusing on your careers. We're looking for material wealth. So they view you as somebody who left them out in the cold, Cancer. They feel like this is over. Could be dealing with a Scorpio, but they feel like this is over. Somebody here could be having an issue using their intuition, or somebody here could be opening up about something. Something could be revealed here. So both of you guys are looking for stability and long-term commitment here. I said that with the first card when the first card came out. So both of you guys are looking for a family, You know, this is the white picket fence, the family and material stability. This is material security. So both of you guys want a family. They view you as somebody who left them out in the cold and blocked them, or was very defensive against them. Somebody could be having some money. They could view you as somebody who's having some money issue, or you could, they could view you as somebody who's having some money problems. So they feel like this is over, and either they feel cold and detached towards you, or they feel you're being cold and detached towards them. Could be dealing with a Gemini. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. So it could be revealed that somebody else here, that somebody here is dealing with somebody else. It could be revealed that you're dealing with somebody else, Cancer, because this is you. This is you. So do you have your eye on somebody else, or does somebody else have their eye on you with this King of Cups? This is somebody who has a lot of emotion and who wants to offer the emotion, but they don't always show it. So are you going to reveal, or this is you revealing the emotion that you actually have for them? So this could be you going from cold and attached to somebody who's a little bit more open about their feelings. Oh, yes. It's a lot of love here. It's a lot of love here. Both of you guys have love for each other. But you guys want the same thing. So this person views you as somebody who maybe is blocking them out or not allowing them to get close to you because you're trying to avoid another disaster or avoid a disaster with this person. They feel like you want to be single. So they feel like you're being cold and attached because you want to be single. So there's a third party here. This is my third party card. Cancer, I feel like you want to be with somebody else. And I think it's going to be revealed that you want to be with somebody else. I feel like it's going to be revealed that you want to be with somebody else, but the other person wants to work on this. Yeah. You want to be with somebody else. They want to work on it, but you want to be with somebody else. You could have been dealing with somebody else all along. Okay. So I don't really see where this is coming back together either. Or you could have a hard time opening up your emotions because of past heartbreak. And you want to work on having an even give and take or an even balance with this person. Okay. So that's two scenarios here. It could be revealed that you want to offer your emotion somewhere else, somebody you are already dealing with, while this person wants to work on it and have balance. That's storyline number one. The second one is you could have a problem opening up and showing emotion due to past heartbreak. And this person wants to work on it. Still, they want to work on it and get some kind of even give and take. So that's storyline number two. Why is this three of swords here? No. How does Cancer want to move forward with this person? Bottom of the deck. I think you are tied and bound. I think you're confused and don't know which way to go, to be honest, because you're dealing with more than one person, Cancer. You're dealing with more than one person. It is clear that this person, the other person that you're dealing with, the person in this spread wants to work on this. It is you who, because they view you as left out in the cold, as you left them out in the cold, and you defense and you're defensive against it, you block them. They feel like it's over. They feel like you're being cold and attached, and they feel like you want to be single. You don't want to be single. You actually want this over here. You just don't want it with them. I think you're confused about who you want it with, to be honest with you. So Yeah, I don't really see this coming back together, like I said. Okay, Cancer. And let's do Pisces. Give me a message for Pisces. I love message for Pisces. Give me a love message for Pisces. Love message for Pisces. Love message for Pisces. Love message for Pisces. So the mutual energy between you guys is a justice in reverse. So I don't feel like this is a reconciliation or neither one of you guys want to reconcile. And I feel like somebody here or both of you guys feel like each other did them wrong. Okay. They view you as not wanting a new beginning, not wanting anything stable and new. So not a new beginning with them. They feel like you are, I get the feeling that they feel like you're the perfect woman. You're somebody who, I feel like they feel like you could have been their wife, or you could be their wife, the mother of their children. You could actually be the mother of their children. But I feel like they feel you're the perfect woman, or you're the right woman for them. And the outcome is a Two of Swords. So somebody here is blocked. Somebody here is indecisive and not making a decision, refusing to make a decision. It's a stalemate, stagnation, confusion here with that moon. And somebody could just be blocked. So I feel like you guys both feel like you were done wrong in this love relationship. They view you as not wanting to communicate about a new beginning. Okay. So you may be communicating with them, or they view you as somebody who wants to communicate, but you don't want to talk about a new beginning. They feel you're avoiding. So even though they feel like you are the perfect woman for them, or that you are wife material and all that kind of stuff, they feel like you're avoiding them. Could be trying to avoid another disaster, or avoid a disaster. Somebody here could have a choice between two people with this King of Pentacles. They could be trying to make a decision. I believe some kind of information came in, or somebody rushed in with some kind of truthful communication that talked about whatever happened in this love relationship here. There could be a lot of arguments here. Both of you guys could be argumentative. They view you as somebody who's ghosted the relationship. Somebody who's moved away or walked away from the relationship. Could be dealing with a Virgo. I honestly feel like they think that you're seeing somebody else. with this three, with these three people in this Three of Pentacles. They feel you're dealing with somebody else. And I feel like somebody rushed in with some kind of communication or truthful communication about the relationship and the injustice. Okay. Whew, what I said. Okay, the lovers is about, you know, a love relationship, one with a very strong connection, could be dealing with a Gemini, but also the lovers is about decisions and choices. I feel like somebody here has a decision to make between two people. Yeah, you got somebody rushing in with that is very passionate here with this Knight of Wands, Pisces. This could be, so you could be dealing with a fire sign and an earth sign. Okay. One of them stable, one of them the King of Pentacles. Be careful now, because this Knight of Wands is a player and somebody who's not consistent. This is Knight energy. But you got a decision to make. So things are at a stalemate because somebody here has a decision to make. So things could come back together. It just depends on the choice that you make, Pisces. Okay. So I hope these readings were helpful for you. Hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notification bell. I'm trying to get to 100 subscribers by the end of March, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.